Colliery Calcio, Wikipedia article audio. Colliery Calcio is an Italian football club based in Colliery, Sardinia. The club currently plays in Serie A. They won their only Scudetto in 1969-70, when they were led by the Italian national team's all-time leading scorer, Luigi Riva. The triumph was also the first by a club from south of Rome. Colliery's colors are blue and red. History. Before Serie A. The club stadium is currently being rebuilt into the 21,000-seat Stadio Sant'Elia in Colliery. As of the 2017-18, the team is temporarily playing their home games at the 16,000 Sardina Arena, adjacent to the new stadium site. The club's best European performance was in the 1993-94 UEFA Cup, losing in the semi-finals to Internazionale. Colliery became the first ever outright champions of Serie C during the 1951-52 season. Prior to that in the league, the championship was shared amongst more than one team. They spent the 1950s from then on in Serie B, losing a promotion playoff in 1954. After descending to Serie C in the early 1960s, Colliery's rise would be meteoric, eventually achieving promotion to Serie A in 1964. The squad for the Rossoblu's debut season in Serie A featured players like defender Mario Martiradonna, midfielders Pierluigi Serra, Nene, and Ricciotti Grady, and forward Luigi Riva. A poor first half of the season, however, saw Colliery in last place with 9 points at the halfway mark. An astonishing second half of the season saw Colliery defeat the likes of Juventus and Milan and finish in 7th place with 34 points. 2 seasons later, Riva finished as Serie A's top scorer for the first time while Colliery finished with the league's best defensive record. During the summer of 1967, Colliery played a season in North America as part of a fledgling league called the United Soccer Association. This league from Europe and South America to play in American and Canadian cities, with each club bearing a local name. Colliery played as the Chicago Mustangs, and finished joint second in the league's Western Division with 13 points. 2 behind the division champion and eventual league champion Los Angeles Wolves. The league's leading scorer was Chicago/Colliery's Roberto Bonansegna, who scored 10 goals while playing in 9 of the team's 12 games. First Serie A adventure, 1964-1976. Colliery first emerged as serious Serie A title contenders in 1968-69 with a three-horse race involving them, Fiorentina and Milan. Fiorentina would win the league, but the following season would bring ultimate glory. With Angelo Domenghini joining the side, Colliery would win the title in 1970 with only 2 games lost, 11 goals conceded and Riva as league top scorer once more. Players like Albertosi, Nicolette, Bonansegna, Gori, Serra, Domenghini, and Riva played in Italy's 1970 World Cup final team. The 1970s would see a gradual decline. Colliery were finally relegated in 1976, with Riva's career having effectively ended during that season. Up and down again, 1976-87. After relegation, Colliery lost a playoff for promotion the following season and would return to Serie A in 1979. Players like Franco Salvaggi, Mario Brugnera, and Alberto Marchetti ensured a respectable 4-year stay in the top flight before a second relegation in 1983. The 1980s would then prove to be a darker time compared to the previous two decades, with relegation to Serie C1 in 1987. Cagliari spent two seasons in Serie C1. In the first one, it barely avoided relegation in Serie C2. In 1988, Claudio Ranieri was appointed coach, and led the team to two successive promotions, to Serie B in 1989 and to Serie A in 1990. The first two seasons back in Serie A saw Cagliari fight relegation, with safety being achieved by excellent second-half runs. But the 1992-93 season would see Cagliari fight for a European place and succeed under the management of Carlo Mazzone. The following season saw a run to the semi-finals of the UEFA Cup, unprecedented for the Sardinian club. The next few years would see Cagliari return to mid-table anonymity, before a struggle in 1996-97 saw Cagliari relegated after losing a playoff to Piacenza. Once more they bounced back after just 1 year, but their next stay in Serie A lasted just two seasons. There and back, 1987-2000. Cagliari spent the next four seasons in Serie B, for most part in mid-table mediocrity. But 2003-04 would see the Rossoblu, led by Sardinian-born Gianfranco Zola, mount a successful promotion challenge, and the following season saw Cagliari hold their own in Serie A with a respectable mid-table finish. The following season was a quiet one for the Sardinians; they obtained a good mid-table position. Once and again, 2000 onwards. The 2005-06 season, the first without Zola, started in the worst way possible for Cagliari, who changed their manager three times, with Attilio Tesser, Daniel Arrigoni and Davide Ballardini alternating to the position of coach, before Nino Sonetti, appointed in November, was able to save the team from a relegation thanks to goals from Honduran striker David Suazo. For the 2006-07 season, Marco Giampaolo was signed as head coach, however he was fired after the 17th match and replaced by Franco Colomba. However, after a number of poor performances which ended in a 2-0 home defeat to Lazio, Colomba was sacked, and chairman Celino chose to reinstate Giampaolo as head coach. Giampaolo was confirmed for the 2007-08 season, and his contract was extended for two more years. Colors, badge, and nicknames. The 2007-08 season saw the flagship strikers David Suazo, Mauro Esposito, and Antonio Langella leave for Internazionale, Roma and Atalanta respectively, and the experienced goalkeeper Chimenti leave for Udinese. The club reinforced itself with youngsters likes Robert Acquafresca, Alessandro Matri, Pascal Foggia, Argentine Joaquin Larrivi and Slovenian Janko Privek. Nino Sonetti returned to coach the Rossoblu in November 2007 after Giampaolo was relieved of his duties as a result of poor results in the first part of the 2007-08 Serie A season that saw them sink to the bottom of the Serie A standings. In the January transfer window, Cagliari made changes to their squad with goalkeepers Vincenzo Maruoco and Marco Fortin replaced by Marco Storri and Luca Capucci, along with experienced striker Gita, and the Sardinian midfielder Andrea Casu. With these new players, Cagliari won many matches and continued their climb up the table, eventually ending the season at 14th. The 2008-09 season saw Cagliari start their season badly, losing their first five matches. Despite their rough start, however, they went on to end the season at a comfortable ninth place, 19 points above relegation. Cagliari's coach, Pier Paolo Bisoli, was fired on November 15, 2010 and replaced by former Italy and Napoli coach Roberto Donadoni, who was himself sacked on August 12, 2011. Honours. Cagliari started the 2011-12 season with Massimo Ficcadenti as head coach, then replaced by comeback man Davide Ballardini. A few weeks before the end of season, however, Ballardini was removed as head coach due to poor results and Ficcadenti was reinstated. At the end of the season, Cagliari has played their home games at Stadio Nerio Rocco in Trieste, after the historical club stadium was closed down in March 2012. Cagliari Youth Stadio is arenas in Quarcu Sant'Elena as its home venue for the 2012-13 season, coming back to the Sant'Elia in the following season. Cagliari were relegated from Serie A in the 2014-15 Serie A season. They gained promotion back to Serie A the following season after finishing in first place in Serie B. The official red and blue colors of Cagliari mirror those featured on the stemma of Cagliari. The red parts of the stemma are a reference to the coat of arms of the House of Savoy, a family which was previously the monarchy of Italy and more relevantly to Cagliari in particular, the Kingdom of Sardinia. The blue part of the stemma features the sky and the sea, also a castle. This is because the old historic center of Cagliari is walled and called the Castello. Due to the use of these colors on their shirt and halves, the club is commonly nicknamed Rossoblu. Cagliari have had several different logo designs during their history, all of which feature the flag of Sardinia. Usually the badge also features the club colors. If there is a change, the main difference has been the color of the border or the shape. Currently, the badge features an old French-shaped escutcheon with red and blue halves, with the club's name written in white just above the flag of Sardinia. The Moor's heads have, for the first time, been turned to the right as of 2015 so as to match the Sardinian flag after it was updated in 1992. Due to the fact that Cagliari are the main club from the island of Sardinia, they are nicknamed the Isolani. National titles: UEFA Cup. European titles. Note: flags indicate national team as defined under FIFA eligibility rules. Players may hold more than one non-FIFA nationality. Note: flags indicate national team as defined under FIFA eligibility rules. Players may hold more than one non-FIFA nationality. 11 Luigi Riva, forward, 1963-78. 13 Davide Astori, defender, posthumous honor. Including only players with at least 100 appearances in the club or an appearance Indiana a FIFA World Cup. Players. Current squad. On loan. Retired numbers. Cagliari have had numerous presidents over the course of their history, some of which have been the owners of the club, others have been honorary presidents. Here is a complete list of them. Cagliari have had many managers and trainers. Some seasons they have had CEO managers running the team. Here is a chronological list of them from when they founded in 1920 onwards. Notable former players. Presidential history. Managerial history. In Europe. European Cup. UEFA Cup. UEFA non-organized seasonal competitions. Inter-Cities Fairs Cup. World Cup winners.